The Town Hall 2 player with the highest trophies in the world is going to share his story with you, the attack strategies used, and exactly how he did it. Welcome back to the channel then, guys. I'm your host, Judo Sloth. A subscriber recently reached out to me because he is now number one in the world when it comes to trophies as a Town Hall 2. He sent me information of a clan he had set up in order to share this with me, and there he is, spun a Town Hall 2 with 2,865 trophies. But look at his troops. Level 1 Barbarians, Archers, Giants, and Goblins. I am genuinely interested in exactly how he did this, not just the attack strategy he used, but maybe some of the finer details. The little tips that allow a low Town Hall level to push this high up in trophies, and I can share that with you. I mean, look at the troops that he has. So let's go ahead and request to the clan. Congratulations. And maybe at the end of the video, you will be inspired to give this a try yourself. I had a great conversation with Bjorn, not just the attack strategy he used, but he told me about Town Hall 2 base building, time management with this trophy push, and I'm going to discuss all of it with you. Maybe some people can relate from back in the day, but he would sit for hours in the clouds. This was actually the most recent attack that he did, so it's why I wanted to show you it first. I have a couple of replays to show you, but against a Town Hall 4 as a Town Hall 2, it is incredibly difficult. I'll go into a little bit more depth about the attack strategy, but I do want to say that when he started the trophy push, he said the super wizards are what he always used in the clan castle, offensively and defense. But that changed in the last update, so you can no longer do that. And I did ask him, if anybody wants to follow in your footsteps, what clan castle troops should they use? The baby dragon is what he said, both on offense and defense. He did say that the Valkyrie is a good alternative on defense, but the baby dragon appeared to be a little bit more consistent, and it's easier if you're then using it with your attack. Because I do have other replays, depending on the Town Hall level, depends on what he tried to get. But against a Town Hall 4, the mortar was what he always aimed for. And that is because he was using a barch strategy. You do want to take a heavier influence of archers. And the reason for that is simply you cannot lose. As a Town Hall 2 going up against Town Hall 4 bases, it's hard to get the 2-star, and if you lose when you are this high up in trophies, you lose a lot of trophies. So you need to pick the surrounding buildings off with the archers. The strategy differed slightly depending on the level of Town Hall he found. However, I do want to talk a little bit about base design, because this is something I hadn't thought of. A quick history lesson here for you. Nowadays, you always tend to see the Town Hall within the base itself, even lower down when the Town Hall's not a defense. However, we always used to see the Town Hall on the edge of the base. Hands up, leave me a comment if this was you. I did it. I used to have my Town Hall on the edge of the base, just giving it away. This was due to a number of factors. Firstly, the Town Hall never used to be a storage like it is now. So when somebody took your Town Hall, they didn't get any loot. However, if they decided to destroy the Town Hall and then just leave, gaining a star, you would receive a shield. And that meant that you were basically protecting your loot all of the time. So Clash of Clans changed this. It was many years ago, but now in order to get a shield, the opponent not only has to have a certain destruction of your base, but they also need to deploy at least 1/3 of their army. This is actually why the Town Hall 2 world record is held by Pelican Tacos in the Titan League, because he was able to snipe Town Halls. The base is spread out like this on purpose. This was the base that he used to defend, because he said, you will take a 3-star defense all day long as a Town Hall 2. But again, if the opponent did not use 30% of their army, he would only receive a 30-minute village guard. So the reason he pushed the base out like this is not that it's going to defend, but it's to try and give the perception that they could time fail and encourage them to use more of the army. Honestly, I thought that was really cool because it's something I wouldn't have thought of. I want to show you a couple of the other attacks that he shared with me whilst I discuss some of the finer details. This one, arguably not the best base design in the world, but he is going to take that, right? If he can take apart an air defense that is misplaced and use the baby dragon elsewhere, then that is exactly what he is going to do. And in this case, once the air defense is down, he used archers and the giant to the most southern archer tower and the baby dragon to the most northern one. Now, whilst he can deploy the rest of the archers to assure that he doesn't time fail, the baby dragon can literally clean the rest of the base. So if you are pushing in trophies, it's all about the baby dragon. But I do want to talk about shield management and time management because that was a huge thing. Basically, he would always buy shields and rotate around them. Unfortunately, he would have cooldowns at various points and take a defense where he would get 3-starred, but buying shields is a must if you want to push high. Every once in a while, he would find a Town Hall 2 or 3 and have a much higher probability of the 3-stars. In this instance, the defending baby dragon, exactly what he advised. So to take that out, distracts it with archers and uses his baby dragon to do so. But one thing I thought was interesting was you search for hours. What happens if you find a base that you are unsure about attacking? Do you click next in order to wait the whole time again, or do you keep going? The answer I found interesting, so I'm glad I asked the question. If he had a shield, he would keep nexting. So basically, when you first try and find a match, you lose part of your shield, but it does not cost you to next. So he would keep nexting in order to find a base that he could 3-star or that offered a high amount of trophies. But since he had to wait that long in the clouds, if he was not attacking through a shield, so therefore he was going to hit the personal break sooner and get kicked off the game, taking a defense, that is when he was a lot more risky and he would just attack any base. Because right up here in trophies, you are getting 3 trophy offers, for example, but if you lose or take a defense, you will concede a lot more than that. But after an average of 12 to 36 hours searching in the clouds, is what he said it was per attack, you never know when you would find a base with a higher amount of trophies, and a nice easy one for the 3-stars, to be fair. The low Town Hall trophy pushing scene is super competitive, and I kind of want to give a bit of a shout out to all of those players. I know how much effort they put in. A big thank you to Spion for sharing his journey and exactly how he does this. What it takes, the attack strategies that were used, arguably pushing with all of your friends and being in this competitive environment is what keeps them going, but I hope you have enjoyed this one. If you do want to see when I shared the story of a Town Hall 6 legend player, I have it linked on your screen alongside the subscribe button. You guys take care, and I will see you in the next video.